Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So students, in the last lecture we have seen that what is order of reaction, and based on that we have also seen that what is rate law, and depending on that we have evaluated a formula also. So based on that formula we are going to solve a numerical. So let us see what is the numerical. So friends, on your screen as you can see there is a numerical which is based on order of reaction. So before solving this numerical we should know that how to extract the data that is present in the question. So first of all let us see, and what are the requirements also we will also evaluate that thing. So first of all let us see the question. The question says the rate law for the reaction, that is C2H4Br2 plus 3 times I minus gives you C2H4, that is ethene, plus 2 times Br minus and I3 minus, and the rate law has already been mentioned in this numerical. So it will be very much easy for us to solve the numerical. And what is the rate law given for this reaction? It is the rate is equals to K, that is rate constant, and concentration of C2H4Br2 raised to 1 and I minus also raised to 1. So the rate of the reaction was found to be 1.1 into 10 raised to minus 4 moles per second. Moles per second, in the sense we could also write it as moles per dm cube per second. And the concentration of C2H4Br2 and the concentration of I minus are 0.12 molar and 0.18 molar respectively. And based on that, we have to calculate the value of rate constant. So first of all, the thing that we should do is we have to extract the data from the question. And how can we extract? Let us see each one by one. So the first data that I have been mentioned in the question is a reaction. But the most important thing is the rate law is also mentioned in this question. So this plays a very important role to solve this numerical, because it is an experimental value of X and Y. So they are already present, but we have to mention that also. So let us see how can we mention. So in the given data, the rate law is already mentioned, that is rate is equals to K of C2H4Br2 and I minus. In this thing, if I consider this reactant to be A and this reactant to be B, then according to rate law, we have a formula. Rate is equals to K A raised to X and B raised to Y. So in this thing, there is no number mentioned here, which means the value of X in this case is 1 and the value of Y in this case is also 1. So therefore, X is equals to 1 and Y is also is equals to 1. So what is the next data that they have provided? They have provided that the rate of the reaction is 1.1 into 10 raised to minus 4 moles per second. So therefore, I could write the rate of reaction as rate is equals to 1.1 into 10 raised to minus 4 moles per second. And the next data that they have provided is the concentration of C2H4Br2. So V represent the concentration in terms of square bracket C2H4Br2, which is given as 0.12 molar, and that of I minus is given as 0.18 molar. And based on this thing, we have to calculate the value of K. Now, it is very much simple because the given data has itself the formula of the rate law. And the only thing that we have to do is we have to substitute the value in that equation and we'll get easily the value of the rate constant. So by substituting the values in the above rate law that they have mentioned, I could say 1.1 into 10 raised to minus 4 is equals to K concentration of C2H4Br2, which is nothing but 0.12, multiply by concentration of I minus, which is given as 0.18. So therefore, the value of K would be 1.1 into 10 raised to minus 4 divided by 0.12 into 0.18. So by solving this, we get a value of 50.92 into 10 raised to minus 4. So before giving the unit, we should understand that this is which order of reaction. As the value of x is also 1 and the value of y is also 1, so therefore it is a second order reaction. So I could write the unit as follows. As you can see, since the k is nothing but rate divided by the concentration, so I could write the unit of the rate as moles per second, and that of the concentration of reactant A and reactant B. Again, the concentration of A in this case will have a value, that is moles, that is moles per dm cube, and that of B will also be moles. So therefore, what will happen is we could get an answer moles per second into moles and moles, which means nothing but the answer would be, or the unit of this rate constant would be per mole per second. So the value of the rate constant now is 50.92 into 10 raised to minus 4 per mole per second. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have got an idea how to solve a numerical based on rate law or order of reaction. So don't forget to subscribe eKida channel. Thank you so much.